We'd like to welcome you to the Black Cat Cabaret. Please be patient with our servers. We are not professional servers. So be kind and hopefully we can all have a lot of fun. We'd like to start off with our 7th grade jazz band during this time. We're going to start off with a tune to set the mood, I hope, with a tune called Latin Lady.
Thank you.
Our next tune is a classic jazz standard tune called Night Train.
Thank you.
Okay, just a couple of quick announcements that I'd like to make. First off, for those of you who don't know anything about jazz music, it's a lot different than playing normal concert band music. We have to take our normal language of reading music and then reinterpret that to be able to swing and play different styles of jazz. So it calls on a whole nother realm of understanding to be able to do that. The soloists that you hear are standing up and doing improvisation solos. Okay, they're making them up based on theory and knowledge of chord structure and all that stuff, and basically kind of flying by the seat of their pants. But they're making up those solos. They are not written. So talk about, you know, standing out in front of God and country, standing up and playing a solo, not even having anything really to base it on. So it takes a lot of guts to do that. Let's give our solos. Let you know who a few of those soloists are. We have Mallory Miller up front here. There's Mallory and Steve Stugmeyer and Scott Booth. And over here we have James has moved to Barry Sachs. And our trumpet solo we have Andy Reese. So let's give all those solos a nice round. Okay, the last tune that we're going to do with this group, and then it'll give these guys a chance to chill out and relax, and you guys a chance to eat. We have some other performances of some other types of music, including, I guess I'm gonna get my saxophone out and play a little bit, and then we have a flute trio. So we have some other music for you as well. So enjoy your time here. I got a couple of people I need to thank, but I'll do that after we play the Chicago Standard 25 or 6 to 4. Take a few of us back. No, no. Yeah, okay, good. about that for 7th grade, son? Great job. Okay, there's quite a few people I need to publicly thank. Mrs. Kathy Cooper is probably back in the kitchen. Is she? Hey, there she is. She's waving. Kathy is a saint. She's pulling her hair out. Great. I couldn't have done this without her help. She was our food committee chairperson. She went to Sam's Club and FSO and Bueller's and all these people and baked and looked pitiful, and they gave us a lot of stuff at a cheap price or donated some things. And coordinated all of that stuff, so I need to give Kathy a great round of applause and thanks for super job. Also, back in that kitchen area, our head kitchen person, Mrs. Linda Sell, is back there, volunteered to come in and work to help us today. Let's give her another applause. I just want to tell you a little brief background on this idea. Is I did this with my high school band when I was in high school, and that's what started it. But the kids have done everything here. I've just been the catalyst. They researched what a cabaret was and came up with all that stuff. They had committees that they came up with design and stuff they wanted to serve, wanted to do. Yesterday after school here, we transformed this cafeteria in about 2.5 hours, which is nothing short of a miracle. And the kids really and students have done everything. I mean, I've just been the facilitator. They've done all the designing. As you can see, they're doing all the work, from everything from design to menus to the decorations and everything. And somewhere along the road there, yeah, we're playing music, and we had to learn that too. So I want to give all the students congratulations on a super job at organizing, getting this stuff together. Bear with us, we're going to move some stuff around and give them a chance to be able to relax a little bit, maybe get a bite to eat, and we'll have to check with the kitchen to see how the food's going. We may have to wait on that a little bit. And then we're going to have some canned music here for a little bit, and then we'll have some more live music in just a minute, so if you folks want to...
how many hearts to make
Our next tune is a Latin tune called Paso Robles. I'd like to just make a couple of quick announcements. We have several people that I need to thank. This is no small task to pull something of this magnitude off. We have a person in the back kitchen, nothing short of a saint. She's been a tremendous help and did all the tracking down of the food and prices and buying and getting it here. Kathy Cooper, are you back there? Can you stick your head out there, Kathy? There she is. Thanks, Kathy. Great job. Thank you very much. Also back there, our soup Nazi, Mr. Sauer, back there in the kitchen. Great job, Mr. Sauer, on the French onion soup. Good job. And let's see, back there in the kitchen also, our head cafeteria person, Mrs. Linda Sell, came in and has been here since 8 o'clock this morning. We'd like to thank her for her extra help too today. Give her a nice round. I see several faculty members here. We have Mr. Rush and Mrs. Schafter, Mrs. Radke. Who else is? Mrs. Witten. See, Mrs. Brown was here. I'd like to thank all those faculty members for coming today and coming to join us in our cabaret. So, thanks a lot. We appreciate that. For those who don't know anything about jazz music, the people that are the students that are standing up playing solos, those are not written solos. They are improvised solos, and they have basic chord structure and scalar stuff, but they're making up those solos on the spot. Which is not an easy thing to do. Okay, it's tough enough to stand up and play a solo, let alone making it up as you go along. So jazz music is very different in that way, and also we take our normal note reading, music reading skills, and we have to relearn how to interpret that in a jazz fashion. So there's a whole nother skill that's involved in playing jazz music. I'd like to introduce some of our soloists to you now. Up front here we have Brandon Waltz. Brandon's very shy. Josh Budenat. We've got Tim Westerman. James Liddy on Barry Sax. On trombone, we have Joey Bourgeois, right? Or Bourgeois. Bourgeois, Joey Bourgeois over here on trombone. I botched it for only 4 years now, Joe, sorry. We got Christy Smith on flute. Michelle Frechette. On flute, I got one right. On trumpet, Mike Sloan back there. Great job. Our next tune is a nice soft ballad called Lean Mean Rockin' Machine.
Tracy. Thank you.
few other soloists on that one we'd like to introduce. On guitar, we had Jimmy Parsons. On drum set, Matt Durhammer on that one. Tuba soloist, Sean Brett. But Sean is also very shy. Okay, might as well. Just want to mention a couple other quick things. Basically, I just want to kind of give you the background of this. I did this when I was in high school with our high school jazz band, when I was a member of that group. And it was a lot of fun then, and this was sure a heck of a lot of fun. But basically, I wanted to tell you, I didn't really plan this or do this. I was just a facilitator. The kids did everything from committee meetings and coming up with the ideas and researching what a cabaret was, and all of that stuff was all on the students. They just did all that, came up with the ideas, what food they wanted to serve, and decorating. Like yesterday, we dismantled this cafeteria and remade it into what you see here in about 2.5 hours, and that's because there was a ton of kids here doing a great job. So many times you hear about, oh, well, this one and that one doesn't do what they do. Hey, here's an awful lot of kids here doing an awful lot of good work. So these are the kind of things that we like to focus on and not always dwell on. There's way too much negative stuff that you hear. So let's give these kids a great round of applause. There's a couple people that I didn't get a chance to thank in the first session, but this great looking backdrop here with the buildings and stuff, Mrs. Sloan and Mike Sloan, did the design and put that up yesterday, so and she came and volunteered her time for that, so I'd like to thank her for those decorations. Also, I see Mrs. Viverka back there was a rep from American Greetings, saved us half the price of all our decorations and stuff, saved us a ton of money. Thank you, Kathy Viverka, for your help there. And of course, at the bottom of the menu, you see the list of all the sponsors and local businesses that helped us out. We always talk about how great Wadsworth is, but you go to a local business here and they certainly step up and help any way they can with the school. So certainly your patronage to those people will be greatly appreciated. We'd like to thank all the sponsors on that list. Give them a nice round of applause, please. And then of course, aside from all of this, somewhere along the road, we learned how to make music too. So we'd like to finish this part of our performance of the 8th grade jazz group, and then we do have a flute trio that will perform, and we also have, what do you guys call yourself? We have a special performance, guest appearance by Don't Rock the Boat. Original composition, right? Original arrangement? Okay, that'll come up right after this. They're laughing, they know it. It's cool, you'll like it. And so we invite you certainly to enjoy that. We'd like to finish our part of this performance with a tune called Minor Yours. Or Minor Yours. Yours or mine. His or hers. Them or theirs. Hey, wait, can I do like what? Okay, I'm sorry. I'll be all right. So I'm around these guys too long. So yeah.
you.
Why? Now you taking me, Mom.
Okay, stay tuned. We have Don't Rock the Boat coming up.